Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I will talk about the foot. Okay, when I talk about the foot, I will talk about the skin, then the fascia, then the muscles, vessels, and nerves. Start by the skin, the nerve supply of the skin, the dorsum of the foot. The medial side of the dorsum of the foot is supplied by the saphenous nerve from the femoral nerve. The lateral side of the foot and the lateral side of the little toe by the sural nerve from the tibial nerve. The middle part of the dorsum of the foot by the superficial peroneal nerve. The adjoining sides of the big toe and second toe by the deep peroneal nerve. So this is the innervation of the dorsum of the foot and the digits. The dermatome of the big toe is L5. The dermatome of the little toe is S1. Regarding the sole of the foot, the heel is supplied by the tibial nerve. The medial 2/3 of the sole of the foot and the medial 3.5 toes by the medial plantar nerve and the lateral 1/3 of the sole of the foot and the lateral 1.5 toes by the lateral plantar nerve. Regarding the dermatomes of the sole of the foot, okay, the heel is S1, the medial side is L5, big toe and the second toe, and the other, the lateral side of the sole of the foot, and the lateral 3 toes by S1. Regarding the deep fascia, is thickened around the ankle to form 5 retinacula, 2 extensor, superior and inferior, 2 peroneal, superior and inferior, and 1 flexor retinaculum. We'll talk about the structures passing deep to each one. Regarding the peroneal retinacula, it's only 2 tendons, peroneus longus and peroneus brevis. This is the extensor retinaculum. Structures deep to the extensor retinaculum are the first one from medial to lateral, tibialis anterior, followed by extensor hallucis longus tendon, anterior tibial vessels, deep peroneal nerve, then tendons of extensor digitorum longus and peroneus tertius. Then the flexor retinaculum, structures deep to the flexor retinaculum. The first one is the tendon of tibialis posterior, then tendon of flexor digitorum longus, then posterior tibial vessels, tibial nerve, and the flexor hallucis longus. Regarding the sole of the foot, start by the deep fascia of the sole of the foot. The deep fascia of the sole of the foot is thickened to form a plantar aponeurosis. So what is plantar aponeurosis? Plantar aponeurosis is thickening of the deep fascia of the sole. It is attached posteriorly to the calcaneus. It divides anteriorly into 5 slips, one for each toe. And the function of this plantar aponeurosis is protection of the vessels and the nerves, and it supports the longitudinal arch of the foot. Inflammation of the posterior end of the plantar aponeurosis at its attachment to the calcaneus is called the plantar fasciitis. It causes severe pain during standing. regarding the layers of the sole of the foot. Four layers. The first layer contains two abductors and one flexor. The third layer contains two flexors and one adductor. The second layer contains two tendons and two muscles. The fourth layer also two tendons and two muscles. This is the first layer. Two abductors and one flexor. The two abductors, abductor hallucis, abductor digiti minimi, and flexor digitorum brevis. The medial two muscles are supplied by the medial plantar nerve. The lateral muscle is supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. So the abductor hallucis and the flexor digitorum brevis are supplied by the medial plantar nerve. The abductor digiti minimi is supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. Then we'll go to the third layer, two flexors and one adductor. The two flexors, flexor hallucis brevis, abductor digiti minimi brevis, and adductor hallucis. The medial muscle, which is the flexor hallucis brevis, is supplied by the medial plantar nerve. The other two muscles by the lateral plantar nerve. So far, the medial plantar nerve supplies three muscles, and the lateral plantar nerve supplies also three muscles. The medial plantar nerve, in the first layer, it supplies the abductor hallucis and flexor digitorum brevis. In the third layer, flexor hallucis brevis. The lateral plantar nerve in the first layer supplies only one muscle, abductor digiti minimi. In the third layer supplies two muscles, flexor digiti minimi brevis and adductor hallucis. The second layer, two tendons and two muscles. Two tendons. The two tendons. Flexor hallucis longus, this one, and the flexor digitorum longus. The two muscles, one is inserted into the tendon of flexor digitorum longus, and the other one is taking origin from the tendon. Flexor digitorum accessorius inserted into the tendon of flexor digitorum longus, and the lumbrical muscles take origin from the flexor digitorum longus. Regarding the nerve supply, all these muscles are supplied by the lateral plantar nerve except the first lumbrical muscle, which is supplied by the medial plantar nerve. So the medial plantar nerve supplies four muscles. This is layer four, two tendons and two short muscles. The two tendons, tibialis posterior and the peroneus longus. The two muscles, plantar and dorsal interossei. Dorsal interossei are four, plantar interossei are four or three, and all these muscles, all these short muscles, are supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. Regarding the lumbrical muscles, they are four. First, second, third, and fourth. They take origin from the tendons of flexor digitorum longus. They are inserted into the extensor expansion of the lateral four toes. And regarding the action, they flex the metatarsophalangeal joint and extend the interphalangeal joints. The nerve supply by the lateral plantar nerve except the first lumbrical by the medial plantar nerve. Regarding the interossei, plantar interossei and dorsal interossei. Plantar interossei are three or four. The first one may be absent. Okay. The midline of the foot is the second toe. This is the midline of the foot. The action of the plantar interossei is adduction, movement of the toes towards the midline of the second toe. So pad, plantar interossei, adduction. They are supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. Regarding the dorsal interossei, they are four. Okay. And this is the midline of the foot, the second toe, and the action of the dorsal interossei is abduction, movement of the toes away from the midline. That's why the second toe has two dorsal interossei, dab, dorsal interossei, abduction, and they are supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. Regarding the plantar arteries, medial and the lateral plantar arteries, they are branches from the posterior tibial artery deep to the flexor retinaculum. Regarding the distribution, the medial plantar artery supplies the medial side of the big toe. The lateral plantar artery supplies the lateral 3.5 toes, and the adjoining sides of the big toe and second toe are supplied by the dorsalis pedis artery. So the arterial supply of the toes, medial side of the big toe by the medial plantar nerve, lateral 3.5 toes by the lateral plantar nerve, adjoining sides of the big toe and second toe by the dorsalis pedis artery. Regarding the plantar nerves, medial plantar and lateral plantar, they are branches from the tibial nerve deep to the flexor retinaculum. In the first layer, okay, these are the four layers. In the first layer, the medial plantar nerve supplies four muscles. In the first layer, abductor hallucis, flexor digitorum brevis. In the third layer, supplies only one muscle, flexor hallucis brevis. And in the second layer, supplies only one muscle, first lumbrical. All the other muscles are supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. And thank you very much. Good luck and best wishes.